Hi, I'm Elliot, the Technical Support Manager at Roamer. In this video, we'll show you how to connect your Roamer SMART4 battery to a Victron GX device for easy monitoring. A Victron GX device is any of the Victron Energy products with a GX in its name. For example, here we have the Cerbo GX, but you might have an Acrana GX or a Multiplus GX. The GX device acts as a hub that all the latest Victron components communicate to and are directed by. Because of this, we can feed the GX device information from our battery to better control the charging system and give you the battery info on the Victron display, or even remotely via VRM on your phone, laptop, or even your watch if you have an Apple or a Garmin one. To follow along with this video guide, you'll need a Roamer SMART4 battery, a Victron GX device, a Roamer to Victron GX device CAN bus cable, a Victron CAN terminator. This comes with your Cerbo GX or any other GX device. You might need a link cable if you have two or more Roamer SMART4 batteries, and you'll also need to download the Roamer Smart app on your phone. First, power off the battery if it's not already. We never like to work live unless it's totally necessary. Hold the battery button down for 5 seconds and this will turn the battery off if it's on. Next, find the CAN bus connector. It's the middle of the three connectors here. Remove the waterproof cap and align the CAN bus cable with the cable pointing towards the middle of the battery with the connector, or out from the battery if it's a seat base. Next, with the connector on the top of the battery, push down lightly and rotate the collar clockwise. You'll feel the cable being pulled into the connector as you screw the connector in. Keep light pressure and keep turning clockwise until you can turn clockwise no more. If you have two or more Roamer batteries, you'll be supplied a link cable, which is the M12 connector on both ends. Same applies to this as the CAN bus cable, with the cable pointing towards the middle of the battery. Place it on top and screw the connector in. This will be on one of the outer two ports compared to the CAN bus connector. You'll need to do this at both ends on both batteries. Plug the other end of the cable into the BMS CAN port and attach the CAN terminator. The cable will plug into the BMS CAN port on the left here, and the CAN terminator will plug into the adjacent port just next to it. If you don't have BMS CAN, this would be a Cerbo SGX, an Acrana GX, or a Cerbo GX Mark II. You can use the VE CAN port, do exactly the same. The BMS CAN cable goes into one of the VE CAN ports and the terminator in the port next to it. At this point, we can power up the battery by pressing the button on top. Keep an eye on your GX device touchscreen or remote console, and you should see the battery data appear on screen almost immediately. If your GX device doesn't display battery data, there's a couple of things to check. You may need to configure VE CAN ports for devices without a BMS CAN port. To do this, simply tap on the screen, go to Settings, scroll down to Services, tap on VE CAN port, tap on CAN bus profile, and set the CAN bus profile to CAN bus BMS 500 kilobits per second. If your screen still doesn't display the data at this point, you would need to set the active battery monitor. So go back to Settings, scroll up to System Setup, press Battery Monitor, and then select the battery monitor, which here is our 160 SMART4 on CAN bus. Now when we go back to the main menu on the main screen, you will see the battery data. The battery data you can now access via your touchscreen. You see the percentage here. You can also see the main battery voltage and the current going in or out of the battery at any one time. If we tap on the screen, we can tap on Overview here and then tap on Battery. We now get the battery data deeper within the menus. So we can again see the voltage, the current, and now the wattage going in or out the battery at any one time, the state of charge, but also the state of health. This is an arbitrary measurement of the rough health of your battery at any one time. We can also see a sum of the battery temperatures. This is an average across all of the sensors on the battery. We can then pop into details and we can see the lowest cell voltage, highest cell voltage, minimum and maximum temperatures, the number of battery modules that are online or offline. So we have two battery modules here. If one of them was turned off, this would show one online, one offline. At the moment, we have two online, so that's good. We also have the number of the modules blocking charge or discharge. So if any one of the batteries was, say, too cold to be charged, it would say blocking charge one of one. And then we have the installed versus the available capacity. So the installed capacity of the sum of our two batteries here is 320 amp hours, and the available capacity, because they're around about 45%, is 142 amp hours total at the moment. If we go back one, we can see alarms as well. So if there are any alarms, so low battery voltage, high charge currents, low charge temperatures, you would see these here, and they would also pop up as a warning on your touchscreen or via VRM. We can't see history on the touchscreen. You will see reset history on the monitor itself. That is only accessed through the Roamer Smart app. It won't come through to the Victron Cerbo GX. And then if we tap on device, we can also see some bits about how it's connected. We're connected via CAN bus. Our product is a 160 SMART4 from Roamer. You can give it a custom name if you want, and you can see some firmware versions. Thanks for listening. If you need any more information about a Roamer Smart battery, you can head to roamer.com. We've also now got a knowledge hub at support.roamer.com, and you'll see some more articles about the SMART4 batteries and how they connect to the Roamer GX system on there.